What are we drinking today?
Today, since it is 9:06 and I'm getting off in an hour, I am drinking Hint. It's strawberry lemon infused water. Nice and healthy, hydrating, good for the skin. If you look, my daily skincare routine is awesome. My breakouts are limited.
Well, I'm drinking some Yeti Imperial Stout.
This was not a paid advertisement by him.
Of course it wasn't. And what are you drinking, Dink? Since your camera doesn't work?
I'm drinking a cider.
Did it come with a pack of tampons for you too?
Probably.
Which cider? Because there's so many of them nowadays, you can't just say cider.
It's Rhino Guys. It's a Cincinnati brewery. You guys don't have it there.
Okay.
It's a cider. Apple deliciousness.
Sounds heavenly.
Mm-hmm. Does sound good. Okay. So, what's new since last week?
Planning my trip to California. Should have it narrowed down Wednesday, Thursday-ish. I've got to figure out flights and COVID restrictions. Because half the airlines either want a negative test or a passport sign. So I got to figure out which ones I want to take, which ones I don't, versus which flights I want to leave out of LAX. Because most of them fly out at 7:30. And that's going to be miserable.
Yeah. No, I imagine that would. Trying to fix
I think this. I can squeeze either early noon or like early. I found one at 3 o'clock, but I don't know if I want to land at 8, not get home till about 10, and then go to work the following day.
I mean, there's mostly negatives to that. I don't know if that's a great option of choices.
I had to work half day Thursday, leave work, come home, change real quick, go to the airport, fly, be in California by 3 o'clock.
Okay. I'll be there on 5.
Okay.
What day?
I haven't figured that out yet. I'm thinking June 3rd, I think, or the 2nd.
Oh, sorry. I got plans already.
Oh.
Kelly, we need plans on June 3rd, 4th, and 5th, just to be safe.
4th and 5th. Hey, I'm not forcing anyone out to come visit me.
Could be worse. We could get forced to going into the Cincinnati Zoo or the Columbus Zoo.
We're going to Columbus, yeah.
What's the difference?
Steve Irwin's son films there.
Jack Hanna.
No, completely different people.
I don't.
Whatever.
Didn't Jack Hanna just retire or something? Because the whole dementia thing.
Dementia's wore him over.
Yeah. That kind of sucks. I remember watching him on talk shows. Oh, look, a kitty.
Meow.
Cat. Is that the one that sits weird?
What?
With his is that the one that sits weird with his broken leg?
Kelly is trying to look at the cat.
Okay, here. I'm grabbing him again.
Oh, kitty. So cute.
That's the rule of Zoom.
I don't know if we can show his butthole on camera or not.
We can.
I can try to edit out and put like a flower over it or something. But
Marbles is trying to be safe so he can monetize this. But when we say like fuck, he can't monetize it at all.
Hey, I gave you guys fair warning. I don't care. But if you guys want to monetize this in the future, we can't. It's up to you.
That's all the editing.
I'm not spending all my days editing out and adding bleeps to everything.
No, we're just going to cut that section out. We're just going to be in the middle of the conversation. And
pick up I'm just going to have to do a hard cut.
It's going to be like a hard C movie on Netflix. None of it makes sense.
What was that movie you saw? It was that sniper movie with what's his name that
you saw? Ghost with Billy Zane.
Was that any good?
There's still two more movies after that one.
With him, or did they switch him out already?
Well,
don't they switch him out every time?
He doesn't make the next one, but Trent Bergeron comes back, and then the last one, I think Billy Zane's back in.
Wow. I don't...
There's seven movies in the series.
Okay, who makes them?
The sniper movies. Duh.
No, I mean, like, I don't think Netflix makes them, right? So who's funding this?
It was originally in, like, the early 90s. Or maybe late 90s.
No, I think it was... The first one came out, like, late 90s. Or early 2000s, even. But I just want to know who the hell is paying for these movies to continue to give jobs to actors that I don't remember acting this decade.
Let's see.
And I mean, I know Netflix throws money out like crazy.
1993 projects. Was the original one. And then they made the early 90s. 2002. They really cashed in on that market. And then 2004 came out the third one.
Okay.
The fourth one in 2011, the fifth one in 14, Sniper Ghost in 16, Sniper Ultimate Kill in 2017, and this year, Sniper Assassin's End.
That's actually an idea for the podcast to do.
What?
Is every week we have to
make Rocky watch a crappy movie off Netflix and have him review it.
I was going to say, we all do it.
I already do that anyways.
Yeah, we all watch the same crappy, like some crappy movie. It doesn't have to be crappy. We can watch Maximum Risk.
I mean, there's some gems.
So we're going to have a Steven Seagal rundown.
You mean like the one we got 10 minutes into watching and gave up yes. on because they CG'd Steven Seagal's face on top of yes. a motorcycle's helmet?
Yes.
Because he didn't want to actually be in the movie. And Mike Tyson was in that too, wasn't he?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So you know it's gold.
But I don't even know if he was real either.
Steven Seagal.
Hey, guys got to eat, but...
Mike Tyson.
I don't know.
He got big.
Yeah. Yeah, he did.
He has a nice personality, though. We'll give him that.
So does Kelly.
Well, I mean, what is Steven Seagal doing besides being kind of making movies? Isn't he Russian now?
No.
I know he's given a citizenship to Russia. But I don't know if he even lives there. According or if he's Google, just doing it for fun.
Owns a dude ranch in Colorado. He owns a house in LA and a house in Louisiana.
Okay.
He's selling his house that's bulletproof?
He's selling his house
in Arizona for $3.4 million.
What does he need a bulletproof house if he's bulletproof himself?
I don't know, but I'm interested now.
And what kind of property can you get for that much in Arizona?
Amazing looking is what it is.
He was accused of unlawfully promoting a cryptocurrency in 2020.
That's weird.
You know how hard that's got to be?
How do you unlawfully promote a cryptocurrency?
Haven't figured that out. Good time, so.
So how are we going to convince the other two amigos to join this endeavor of ours?
Ryan says he will when he gets a camera.
Ryan's okay. A dirty liar.
So he's never going to get a camera. Gotcha.
I don't think Method will ever really get on board.
Yeah, because I think Method rather play than waste an hour.
Which is stupid, because we waste hours talking nonsense all day anyways.
Yeah, we do that anyways.
And we waste, I don't know how long, waiting on people. All the time.
Yeah, people. I'm ready. As soon as I go through all my gear.
Mm-hmm. I was, I got frustrated playing PUBG last night because I found a shotgun like once and didn't even get to use it.
Yeah, that's why I don't ever do it.
It feels like the stuff I try to accomplish, I never actually get to, but when I'm not trying to do anything in that game, I find every valuable thing I can possibly find.
And then you die?
And then I die immediately once I collect it all. I don't fire a shot and I get dropped first. The first engagement we come across, someone drops me. And then, oh, look, here's all the ammo and first aids I got and the vest 3 that I got and the sniper rifle that I got. All of it's gone to waste.
I appreciate it because they're not shooting at me.
True. I guess I'm just the rabbit in the scenario getting shot at.
It's all right. Last night, I think the first 3 games, I averaged 5-minute lifespan. It was a little ridiculous.
Yeah, it wasn't great the last couple nights. They've been pretty subpar games.
The hard thing is we don't get on the same game plan. Like certain nights we're all on the same plan. Hey, do this, do that. We're in sync. And other times it's like, oh, one person's on the left, one person's on the right. Somebody's in the house looting something and somebody's on the other side of the map going for a care package.
Yeah, who the fuck goes for care packages?
I wonder who's always going for the care package.
I would not say that somebody is always in a house trying to heal when they're saying they're reloading and they're putting in like 14 boosters and a band-aid. I would never call anyone out like that at all.
Dare say when they're going to release the next PUBG game? Are they going to make a sequel or something to it?
I don't think so. I think they'll release a couple maps and then just ride it out. Because it can be hard to make a sequel to PUBG when it's just a battle royale. So you can continually add to it.
The biggest thing I could see about it being worth being a sequel would be to completely change like the weapons. Infrastructure. No, just the infrastructure for the actual game.
The UI.
Like the UI, the actual engine they're using, like the actually
environments.
Instead of one guy making the game basically by himself, you have a team build it that can actually scale better instead of the hodgepodge that they are currently working with.
Or change weapons.
Yeah, you could do that. But I mean, you could do that now, I think, if they really wanted to.
Halo and do themes. Like, hey, 1 month we're gonna do SMGs and snipers.
Well, they did try that with the like the fantasy game type, the
LARP. They need to bring it back.
And that was great. they also had a sniper crossbow.
Yeah.
Short thing that they did for a bit. That was actually kind of cool. So yeah, they should bring in
more. Yeah, but that's the thing is everybody just played a sniper, so defeated the purpose.
Well, yeah, but I mean you could always switch it up. I mean, the fact that having those gets more people to play because it's a novelty. Who doesn't like a novelty?
I hate novelties.
Of course.
Yeah, they need to bring back Fantasy Pub. That show was fun.
that really was. Gave everyone a role to fulfill.
Yeah.
Team Crossbow, homie.
Well, that's the hard part is, you know, certain people want to play certain things and don't want to switch.
Yeah, Wizard.
I switched to the melee guy, too, every once in a while. It's Kelly T.
Yeah, and I just picked the guy nobody wanted to play, so I could always play that guy all the time.
Which is why I was always the melee guy. Because no one wanted to run around and be the tank.
Big brain.
Everyone wanted the crossbow or the flare gun.
Nobody wanted the crossbow. I don't even want to hear that. Nobody
played with it a lot.
Method never played with it. I played with it every once in a while.
Every time we played, you were always the wizard, except for a couple occasions. What was the fourth one?
The melee boost.
Yeah.
Healer. It was like the healer. Yeah.
Which is an odd position for him.
Yeah, especially since he was usually the last one standing and didn't heal anybody.
He never healed in any game ever.
But I don't know. I'm waiting for the whatever announcement they're going to do for the next Battlefield to see if that's worth playing or getting. Rust is supposed to come out May, I think, for Xbox. They finally ported it over for PC.
What?
Rust.
It's like Ark, but without the dinosaurs. And it's just Ark
PvP.
Yeah.
All the time.
Yep.
Always. And the whole point is raiding. So Dink is going to love that game.
Yep. That's all you do is destroy other people's stuff, take them prisoner, torture them by locking them in a cage, and then they can't get out. Yeah. I mean, we could play it now on Steam, but.
Or not.
You guys would have to be open to playing a PC game.
It's just we don't have enough time.
Yeah, you know how much time we spent on Xbox? You want us to now incorporate Steam in that too?
Yeah, why not? That's the thing I've been thinking. I need to get a capture card for because I don't like using the Twitch app on the Xbox. So if I'm going to stream a console, I would much rather stream it to my PC than I can manage to stream that way instead of the two options that the Xbox gives you.
Or you just start streaming in bikini and get those followers.
No, there's a lot of competition out there.
I'm still trying to... I'll turn my video camera on when Kelly starts walking around in bikinis all the time.
Because that happens very often.
Or when she's feeding. I guarantee I'd get a good following then.
You would get a weird
following. You'll get a very specific following then.
If they pay, I don't really care.
The bad thing is that it's going to be for free for a while before they start having to pay.
You got to drum up the support, you get the following, and then you go pay.
Yeah, that could take a while. It's going to be a lot of free feedings up there on the internet
5 years from now.
you're going to have to have a few more kids, Dave, before it starts actually paying off.
I want to hold off on that surgery.
Have you planned that yet, Dink?
No, I've just got to go to the doctor and figure it out. No way.
More importantly, when's it going to be our next adventure and what state are we going to?
Chicago.
I mean, yeah, I'm thinking Chicago.
I'm so down for Chicago. You know how much stuff I need to put in Method's house.
Yeah, we got to start collecting that now, figuring out what we're going to bring.
I already know.
I mean, it's not like he's going to listen to this, so we can talk about as much as we want.
The fact that I know the TSA agents in Austin, I know I can smuggle something there without it being awkward when I get randomly checked.
Yeah. I got to figure out. I like to pack light. So
I just got to make sure we're on good behavior, because if it goes south the weekend they're here, then she's not going to allow anybody to come up. There were some Bowman. Nope.
Yeah, you're going to ruin it for us.
Fuck, I haven't even think about that.
If you scare the wife away, we're never allowed to come visit.
I told Kelly to start messaging her. That way they can be friends. Just so it's not
setting up wife play dates.
Who's that?
Talking about motherly things.
Who?
So what's it like being a mom? I forgot.
Dink can drive there, so if we need to get something there, Dink can hide it in his car.
True. If it's unwieldy, yeah. I'm thinking of how many small things can we do that will take months, if not years, for him to slowly find. I want like 8 months later him to find something. Be like, how did this get here? What is this?
So something that one of her dad's friends did to like their cabin is he got like 100 G.I. Joes and just started hiding them everywhere throughout their cabin. And he has them in like the trees outside and stuff. Like, because we found one, 4 years ago? Your dad's like, I've never seen that one before. Like, he was hiding them in like, they have like an old oven. They have like a warming, like, you know how the bottom is supposed to be the warming rack?
Yeah.
Like underneath, they have one like that's above, and there was one in like the back corner of it. Somebody said, but like they were just, you just get 100 of them and just start scattering them.
Amy's never going to do that.
Kelly said no, so okay. We're doing it then.
I'm thinking of doing something similar to what we did at Rhino's house. I know someone who recently got an Adobe subscription, so I could probably try to learn Photoshop between now and then and start building out some family photos. Create a family photos.
Thing is, what? Like, we need Dink and Kelly.
Yeah, I was going to say, Kelly has Photoshop. Kelly has all the photo everything.
Okay, that'll work.
We need you guys to do the pre-run to know what's in his house so we know what we mess with.
Yeah.
We're not going up there, though. They're coming here.
I know. That's what we got to figure out between now and actually going there.
Why? We just finally gather a bunch of stuff and start replacing.
Well, now that you've been to Amy on Facebook, I guess you have access to some family photos.
Oh my gosh. She posts more than anything.
Yeah.
Amy. She does a lot of makeup stuff.
Okay. So we replace all her makeup with army camouflage paint. Gotcha.
She would kill you.
You know how expensive that would be.
Let's see.
We Photoshop pictures of Method out with other Joshes from the Josh fight.
Yeah.
How'd that go? Does anybody? I forgot to talk about
it. Little Josh won.
So they awarded it to a little kid, and then they raised a bunch of money for a children's hospital, which I think the kid was a patient at.
Yeah, the kid ended up being a patient, and they ended up raising like $8,000 for it.
And they also raised a bunch of food for like a local food bank in whatever state it was in. Was it Nebraska or Kansas? Nebraska, yeah. I mean, heck, that's pretty cool. Some guy was bored during COVID and planned to fight all the other Joshes in the country.
And they all knew to get pool noodles to fight.
Yeah, that was the deal. I believe the rules were there were three types of fights. There was one fight that was only between guys with his exact name. So it was like Josh, I forgot what his last name was. Swain, yeah. So there's fights between all Josh Swains, who was a rock, paper, scissors fight. And I think there was only one other guy with his name that showed up. So they had one fight, rock, paper, scissors, one round. And I think the creator of the event won. Then there was the fight with the pool noodles, but it was broken up into like groups or something. And then there was like a melee at the end with whoever won those fights with pool noodles.
Yeah. Pool noodles. You got hit with a pool noodle, you were considered dead.
Yeah. And then at the end, they awarded a Burger King crown and a like a knockoff wrestling belt to Lil Josh and crowned him the lead.
It was like a unanimous vote. They all wanted Lil Josh to take.
Yeah.
Huh.
So it was kind of cool. It was a lot better event than the Area 51 raid that never really happened.
Yeah, because they're not stupid.
Yeah, because that would have been actually a lot more deadly if that went down. So sometimes the internet can do something cool. What was that?
I was willing to sacrifice a few people.
Yeah. I would have too.
Yeah, me too. Who wouldn't, right? Who wouldn't be willing to sacrifice a few people to find them aliens?
So what movie are we watching this week?
Well,
I see his eyes stirring.
I'm trying to pull up Netflix right now so I can tell you.
All right, Marvels, pick a number. 1 through 7.
Seven. Yet,
genre.
Whatever the seventh genre is.
Seventh genre or the seventh movie on the top 10?
Seventh genre.
Oh, the seventh movie on the top 10 sounds like it'd be more fun.
What is that?
Synchronic. A lifelong friendship, a missing daughter, and a confrontation with the past that just might change their future. The
top 10.
Anthony,
are you actually on movies or are you on?
Oh, just like, top 10 in the US today.
Top 10 in the US today. Keep going.
If we set go number 7. By genre.
See, mine is Synchronons or something.
Seventh genre is Black Stories.
Black Stories?
Training Day it is.
Training Day?
Yes.
Or if we've already seen Training Day.
Better rewatch it.
Who hasn't watched Training
Day? Yeah.
Or Good Burger.
Yeah, mine's Synchronic. Synchronic?
Synchronic, same thing. It's with Anthony Mackie.
Yeah, that's my seventh movie.
That's what I said.
Okay, let's watch that then.
Well, it's not just movies, it's TV shows too.
Well, that's... I didn't hear you say the name. We can do that, that's fine.
It looks like a horrible movie, so we're going to watch it.
Yes. Or we just start watching all the GOAT or the Sniper movies.
Or watch the popular on Netflix and watch Legally Blonde. Which
Kelly,
is the best.
Kelly said Legally Blonde.
I veto that one just because I've seen it. I think we should pick something random that we haven't seen. And then, because that way we'll all have fresh opinions about it.
Kelly, let me see the remote.
I think that makes, I don't know.
All right, so let me add that to my list. I started watching The Serpent. That was a pretty decent little. All
right. 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 1 through 15.
6.
6 is anime.
No, you're looking the wrong spot. Anime is number, should be number 1.
If I press Y and go through search.
Oh, see, I'm in. If you go to, if you push over to the left and go to categories.
I am on categories.
So 3, anime is 4, black stories is 5, 6 is children and family.
See, on mine, it's children and family is 3.
3?
Yeah.
I mean, I have it as 3. I can see 3 too. But see, I was counting the 3 up top, the dramas, action, and adventure, and romance.
As one. I don't have those.
Oh.
Well, those are our top categories.
Oh, those are, yeah.
Oh, that's why it's popular searches. No, that makes sense. I watch thrillers all the time. That's still at the bottom. I'll never understand Netflix.
I mean, I'm sure the algorithms could be regional, could be user-based, could be combination. Who really knows? So what are we watching, Dink? I picked a number. What is it?
I have family, children and family.
A movie?
No, that's a category. That's a
category.
Okay, children and family.
Dink, what's number 2 on your children and family?
Trending now? Or are you talking about?
No, like on your children and family list, what's the number 2 movie?
Heartland.
Wow.
What's yours?
Hook, with number 1 being Little Rascals.
Yep, they're different.
All right, we'll go off of yours.
Well, here's what we could do. This will give us a good spread on movies. We pick a number, and then everyone pulls up their queue, and that'll give us 3 options to choose from. And then from those, we can vote yay or nay. And that's a true hodgepodge group.
So, children and family? Is that what we're going with?
Well, yours was children and family. Mine was black stories. And then when Marbles pulls up his queue.
Our queue or that category?
Your popular, well, your category.
Go to your categories, and you're going to pick number, so there's 18 altogether. You're going to go to number 16. So you should have 3 up top, which are your top categories.
Yeah, I'm looking at the... Hold on.
Ellie, have you ever seen this? I actually just watched Little Rascals.
I'm pretty sure you just make me watch it.
No. I watched it by myself the other night.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
That you didn't make me watch this?
No. Little Rascals is in my watch again, though.
It's a good movie.
No, you made me watch The Sandlot. It's like the same thing.
Are you guys in movies specifically?
Just categories.
Okay.
You go to movies and then we just pick a number and scroll down. So like if you go to actual movies, like categories, movies. And then Rocky, you scroll down 7 and go over 8 movies.
Seven is my continued watching.
That's so, dramas for me.
I only have four on that list. So okay, that would put me. So if I did.
Go to your eighth one then. All right. So
is there a randomizer on here?
Oh my God.
Somebody give me two numbers.
Okay, so hang on. Let's do this from the start.
I think everyone's lists and categories is different. And what...
So I will say we'll use the preface point, continue watching. Nobody just ever pick line one because that'll always be line one for us.
Mine's popular. If you land on continue watching, you just scroll the next one.
Okay, so I'm on popular. That would be line one.
Popular on Netflix, yeah.
And then trending now is line two?
Yes.
No. Okay. Mine's new releases.
This is all sorts of fucked up. Okay, so go to movies.
Okay, well, let's just pick popular or new releases or trending.
You go on whatever movie it clicks on. So when you click on movies, it's whatever the first one is, number one.
It's my list, Netflix originals, then trending, then watch again.
So if it's your list, if somebody picks number one, then you got to go to your list. So if I say Marvel's 1-7, so you scroll over to the right.
Yeah, that's the Siege of Jeddaville.
Well, that's not your number.
Well, that would be, yeah. Okay, that would be 7 for me. Okay, so, what's my number? Okay, so pick a number. I'll pick one.
You're going to go down 9 and over 2. Rocky, give me
two numbers. Wow, it's comedies, Monty Python and the Holy Grail.
Damn, that's a good choice. Tink, we are going to go down 5 and over 6.
Blockbuster movies.
Monty Python and the Holy Grail.
Olympus Has Fallen.
Okay.
All right, Marbles, now you give me.
Go down 4 and go over 3.
Oh, dear God. Thunder Force.
What is it?
Thunder Force.
Oh, yeah.
That movie is so hard to get through.
I can't watch that again.
No, I can't either. That one's getting mixed.
Thunder Force.
You watched it already?
Yeah.
When?
Wow. All right. So
it's either Olympus Has Fallen or Monty Python.
No.
Okay, Kelly.
Monty Python.
Kelly decides. Monty Python?
That's one of, yeah. She likes it.
All right. Monty Python it is. We watch Monty Python and the Holy Grail.
Yeah, we're just going to watch a random movie and then discuss it and find funny scenes. So nothing.
The whole movie?
So we're just going to quote the entire movie. Got it.
Yeah, pretty much.
So nothing. Got it. It's actually one of the one movies that I like don't like that much.
Life of Brian, another gold.
I only saw that one once. I don't remember a whole lot from it.
The Meaning of Life. Oh no, that's not the right one. The Meaning of Life is the one. The Meaning of Live is their life stories.
I don't know why Ryan streams if he never changes his title. He always streams PUBG.
I don't know. Don't know what to tell you. That was one of the reasons why I wanted to ask you getting a capture card so that way I can edit it a lot easier.
Yeah, it is a lot easier.
Midstream, if I switch games, I can easily just type in a new title. Or end the stream and start it again for a different game.
The Monty Python before the end of the week. Got it. Not going to be hard to do at all.
No, I was just saying, usually, because we know Method's never going to do this. That's why I was saying normal. I think Tuesdays would be the better day, too. Because Rocky's going to get on for the 45 minutes after work anyways.
Yeah.
And then he'll just get off, because that'll be about how long he's on for.
Okay.
A little powwow. Either Tuesdays or Wednesdays, because Wednesdays he's always playing soccer, too.
Can't be Thursday, because he's always doing something. COVID didn't stop that guy.
Then that would give him an excuse. If he wanted to try it out, he can come on real quick. He'd still have time with the family.
I mean, we don't have to pick a exact recording day, since I'm thinking that this is going to be probably a weekly thing. So what we need to settle on would be release date, not date, but like what day of the week do you want this to come out?
Make it whatever day. We just need to figure out when we're going to record the stuff for the day. And I would prefer to have it beginning of the week, so that way we can edit it and have it released by the weekend.
Or refilm if we need to.
Yeah.
Okay. So we could do
Tuesdays around 9 o'clock.
Yeah,
that works.
Like what we did tonight.
Okay.
That way we can just get in the habit and kind of wing it from there.
Yeah, we could do that. I'm gonna stop the recording. Actually, I'm worried because it said 40 minutes and we're at 53. And it's still recording.
Popped up on mine that says you guys have unlimited time. Thank you.
Yeah. That's why I asked if you paid for it.
Yeah, no. I have not.
Well, the other thing I wanted to try out too was the Google meetings. Since we all have Gmail, is that the same thing?
There's also Facebook too.
Yeah.
I just don't know if I want to put all my stuff on Facebook for them to double record off of.
Yeah. I mean, I'm recording this, so it does give me a copy locally. And I don't know if Zoom keeps a copy or not. So
I'm sure they do. Everybody keeps everything.
I mean, yeah. Probably. I just don't know. I know that if I recorded on Facebook, they would use it for some sort of marketing thing.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know what...
I'm tempted to try Google's Hangouts.
Yeah, we could try... we could try that right now, just see if it works.
It does. Me and Kelly used to talk on it all the time.
No, I mean like to actually record and stuff. How that works out.
I don't even know what you guys used to do on Google Video.
Since Dinx doesn't have a working camera, I don't know if I want to release this one.
Why?
I don't know, because it's just weird that you're just a box, a black box. If this was audio only, it wouldn't matter.
I think it's fine. I mean, it's just... What?
Do you guys want to release these on, like, the audio sites?
What, sorry?
Do you want to release these as audio, also audio podcasts?
Sure. Is that the point of a podcast?
Yeah. I thought of a video one because I could upload it to YouTube for free. If we...
Until we get into the hang of it, and then we can start divvying out from there.
Yeah, because to use the services that publish them to all the different podcast sites, usually you have to pay like a subscription. And you have so many megabytes per, you know, month that you're allowed to upload.
Let's hold off on that until we figure all this out, so that way when it does get out there, it's not just a whole bunch of like, oh, this is stupid.
Yeah. Yeah, we can do that.
No, I think posting it's fine though. I mean, I said my camera's not working, so I'll have it fixed by the next time.
You better. You're off the team.
I guess I could have got my phone.
All right. Well, we're about an hour anyways.
High five. Job well done, team.
Great job, everybody.
Grail is our homework.
All right. See you guys next time. Bye.
Have a good day. I need off.